A very common and a very popular question that people ask me all the time is, Andrew, what kind of home improvements should I be making to my home that are going to actually add value to my home and help boost my home's value? Well, whether you're looking at selling and you're getting ready for that to get the best price out of your home, or if you're simply owning and wondering what improvements should you be making to your home, they're going to assist you not only in your right now living in the house enjoyment, but also your future resale value, you're in the right place. And in today's episode, we're going to take a look at the best home upgrades to boost your home value. My name is Andrew Finney, your real estate geek. If you need help finding a top agent where you live, or if you simply want to drop me a line to say hello, my contact info is below. If you're new here, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel now and like this video. To get notified of the next episode, tap the bell icon. Thank you. Okay, team, let's take a closer look at this together, because not every home renovation is actually going to add value to your home. And even if you choose the right option and the right kind of upgrade done incorrectly or done poorly, it will not add value to your home, but it could actually subtract value from your home. So let's help you get it right today, leading in with the 9 upgrades that are going to help boost your home value. The first one is indoor systems. And now you might be saying, Andrew, well, what do my indoor systems have anything to do with my home value? Turns out quite a bit. A lot of buyers are going to be more concerned before you even think about adding a bathroom to your home or doing any upgrades in your home or adding additional square footage. They want to make sure that what's already in the home is already working and is going to be okay. Such things as your electrical, your heating, your plumbing, your sewer systems, among others, right? So you want to go back and take a look at each of your indoor systems and make sure that they're completely up to snuff and completely ready to go and in good working order. Some of this just falls underneath general home maintenance. Other stuff falls into that if it's an older home, you might actually need to replace the electrical or some of the plumbing systems depending on the age of the home, right? So it's something that you have to be real about whenever you're thinking about what you're going to do to the home and you plan out your project list. The indoor systems are incredibly important. So it's the same thing if you have an old roof and you know it's time to replace it. Buyers are going to find more value and you're actually going to get a higher return on your investment by making sure that you're replacing these indoor systems. The second point that you can take a look at is actually your outdoor replacement projects. Now, I broke down a few different things and I went over, and I'm looking over here at my notes, by the way, I went over to a website called Remodeling Magazine. I'll make the link available in the show more description below. And I was looking at what they were sharing with us about the replacement value of some little things that add a lot of value. And when I say little things, compared to other things like a major kitchen remodel or bathroom remodel, it's going to be a far less expensive to do a lot of these and you're going to get a pretty good return on investment. So consider replacing your garage door. It comes with a 76.9% return on investment according to the Remodeling Magazine. The next thing is your siding. It comes with a 76.4% return on investment. Your front door. Now here's a shocker. For a couple $100 or a couple $1,000, depending on what you're doing to your front door, it'll come with a shocking 90.7% return on investment. Just your front door. Who would have thought, right? And your windows, 73.9% return on investment. So the magazine definitely suggests a fiber cement or foam backed vinyl siding, adding a steel entry door and a vinyl window replacement. So if you're considering any of those options or upgrades, those are the returns of investment from the Remodeling Magazine. Again, the show more description below has that link available to you so you can check it out and plan out your home renovations accordingly. The third upgrade is your attic insulation. Now it's pretty interesting because with that one, this one is one of the most significant things that you can do that are going to add value to your home. According to the Remodeling Magazine, they actually suggest that the average cost across the nation to add just some additional loose foam into your roof, into your insulation system, is actually going to give you a 107.9% return on investment. That's something very minor, very simple, and very inexpensive that you can do to go ahead and boost and add value to your home. Now, whenever you're making any of these improvements to your property, I want you to keep one thing in mind. I've made a video about it and I suggest that you watch it. And that's about your homeowner journal. You want to keep track of all your receipts, all your projects, and the dates that each of them were completed and have it ready to go. It's going to help you. It's going to help the appraiser and it's going to help you sell your home when you meet with a trusted real estate advisor and they're able to market these selling features to get your home sold. So attic insulation for this third upgrade, very simple, very inexpensive. Go ahead and do it. And in the process, guess what? While you're living there, it's going to do what for you? Reduce your energy consumption, and it's going to make your home more efficient, which is going to do what? Put more green in your pocket by reducing your bills. The fourth upgrade has to do with growing families. A lot of growing families value the bathrooms. And one of the non-negotiables whenever I meet with families here in Las Vegas and I talk to people around the country, sometimes it's like, the difference between a 1.5 bathroom to a 2 bathroom is completely non-negotiable. They're thinking, I need 2 full baths for my house because maybe they have a growing family. Maybe they're planning on having babies or they already have kids. And they don't want to be sharing the tub and the shower with the kids. They want the kids to have their own tub and shower. So it can actually become non-negotiable. So adding this into a house is pretty expensive. Take, for example, you know, with Remodeling Magazine, they suggested that if you live in somewhere like San Diego, California, and you're looking at adding a bathroom to your house, it's going to cost you a whopping topping $50,000. And when it comes time to sell, you're only gonna get roughly 64.2% return on your investment on that. Now, those people living like in the mid-Atlantic region can plan on spending a little bit less at about $46,000, and they'll also recoup a lot less at 48.7%. And if you're on a tight budget or you just don't really see the benefit of adding an additional bathroom to the house, it's okay. There's things that you can do to a bathroom to give it a complete overhaul, a complete new facelift, and make it fresh and new, and it'll still attract buyers and make them really consider how important that additional half bath is to them. If it's a complete non-negotiable, they're gonna go to the next home. But for every family that it's a non-negotiable for, there's gonna be two more in the market that's gonna say, I love that because they renovated it. And that renovations would include ensuring that you have like granite countertops on your counters in the bathroom, a fresh coat of paint, make sure that you have nice sinks, new fixtures, maybe even a new toilet. Make sure that it's not one of those low toilets. You know what I'm talking about too. When you go into someone's house or you go somewhere and it's like that low toilet and you think you're gonna like fall into the toilet, that's not cool. And then, nor is it like when you have the really high toilets and you're like trying to wonder how you're supposed to use the bathroom, right? Make sure that you get an appropriate sized height toilet. It's one of those things that most of us don't really think about or consider, yet from a vantage point of living in the home is gonna have a massive impact. Another extra pop and an extra flair that you're gonna find massively powerful to your bathrooms. While you're living in your home, you're gonna love it, and people that are gonna be looking at your home to purchase in the future are going to absolutely enjoy it. It's very, very, very simple. As opposed to going out and spending all kinds of money for new mirrors in the bathrooms, why not spend the money for a frame and simply frame around the mirror that you already have? It's gonna make it look like it's a custom mirror, and it's gonna add a lot of flair and a lot of pop to your bathroom. Definitely something to think about and something to consider when you're looking at renovating your bathrooms on a budget, okay? The fifth upgrade that you'll wanna do is your kitchen improvement. Now, this one is one that we hear about a lot. I mean, heck, there's shows on DIY, HGTV, Bravo Network, all that fun stuff about how important kitchen remodels are to a home. Should come as no surprise because a kitchen is like the heart of a house. It's where most of us congregate, it's where we prepare our food, it's where we have family time, and it's a source of an enjoyment for a lot of family, and it's a source of continuity and togetherness within the kitchen itself. So it comes as no surprise that in one of Zillow's reports on 2017 about consumer housing trends, that 48% of the buyers listed the style of the kitchen as a desired home characteristic. So with almost half of all home buyers out there desiring a very type of flow for a kitchen and an upgraded kitchen, this is a number to take to heart so that you make sure that you get this right. Now, that doesn't mean that you have to go out and spend a gazillion dollars doing a complete overhaul of the kitchen remodel unless you want to take that massive project on to get that done. I'm sure that you're gonna love it, but make sure that you're doing it right. So when you're looking at doing it right and you're looking at also maybe doing a kitchen remodel on a budget, it's very simple to do. You can do new cabinetry, new kitchen sink fixtures, updated lighting, make sure that if you have no lighting, you get some lighting in there, and make sure that it's bright enough that you can actually see the food that you're preparing. I mean, that's a really kind of a no-brainer, right? But some homes don't have that kind of light. So if they don't have that kind of light and you're trying to prepare something, it could be the difference of putting sugar in a dish that should have been salt. And that would turn out completely wrong. I mean, it sounds a little bit silly, it's a little bit funny, but it's the truth, right? Keep it real and just think about it. What's gonna be the most practical thing that a lot of people are gonna enjoy in addition to you? If you enjoy it or if you have pains with your kitchen, then you already know some of the things that should be remodeled. Another thing is to consider your complementary color palettes. Make sure that whatever kind of granite you're putting in your house or whatever kind of counters that you choose is gonna complement both the floor, and it's gonna complement your appliances, and it's going to complement the color of your cabinets. Now, if you're doing this on a budget, you know, most of us are probably gonna do kitchen remodels on a budget, let's face it, right? You can still increase the value if you're simply sanding down and repainting or staining the cabinetry, and you can give it a custom look, especially if you're doing that. Now, I will suggest that if you're in the between painting and staining, if you can find a good stain and the wood's in good condition, the stain is gonna last longer and it's probably gonna look better than if it's just painted. Paint eventually over time, a lot of times will peel away depending on how it's done. Now, it is a lot of work to do that, but it's one of those things and one of those projects that you can actually do with a lot of sweat equity and then call in somebody to help you stain to make sure the stain goes down correctly. If it's done correctly, it's gonna add a lot of value to your property, and you're gonna get not only the enjoyment factor while you're there, but the buyers coming in are gonna say, you know what, that is the heart of my family, and that is the type of kitchen that I can see my family at the end of the day and beginning the day in the morning and enjoying a wonderful time and getting our family unit closer together. Togetherness is where it's at, and it's one of the most important things. And by the way, don't forget the hardware on those cabinet doors. It's very, very important to have hardware on the cabinets and the drawers in your kitchen, okay? So the sixth upgrade that you would look at is curb appeal. Now, I want you to consider this. Whenever you have television shows dedicated to nothing else than the curb curb appeal, it kind of signifies just how important curb appeal really is to a property. So you want to make sure that you have it done right. Now, if you have a healthy budget and you can do a complete landscaping overhaul, or if your landscape needs an extensive work, always make sure that you consider hiring professionals for the home improvement project. It'll turn out best. A landscape architect may not be cheap, but they're going to really help you out. In fact, Jeff Mitchell over at the American Society of Landscaping Architects, and also known as ASLA, said that curb appeal should not stop at the front door, and it really shouldn't. It should definitely continue to the backyard. How many times have you seen it where you see a home that's beautiful in the curb appeal up front, and you go in the back and you have a disaster zone? It's just like, why did you stop? This just completely killed the mojo, just completely killed the vibe of the home. So make sure that when you take on a renovation project with your landscaping, that you're doing both your front, your back, and your side yards to make sure that everything ties in nicely when you're doing that. Landscaping is critically important. Curb appeal is so important, again, that people have television shows about how to boost your curb appeal. Now, some budget curb appeal tips that you can use is simply lining the walkway with solar power lights. Just doing that is going to be a big home improvement, because then they can see where they're walking up to the front door. It makes your home pop at night. It makes your home look good during the day. You can also green up the lawn by simply keeping it mowed, edged, and reseed any bare spots to make sure that everything is nice and beautiful. You can add color to the planting beds by adding some flowers. Now, I will share this with you as a pro tip. You got to be careful when you're choosing flowers for a lot of different reasons. One of those reasons is if you have a modern home architecture and you're putting something out there that was more suitable for like a Thomas Kincaid painting showing a cottage, it isn't going to flow right. And the opposite is true too. If you have that cottage style home and you're trying to make it ultra modern, it's not going to flow right and it's not going to look right. So consider your home's architecture and design whenever you're thinking about your landscape choices. One of the best things that you can do is go to your local nursery, make sure that whatever you are planting is going to be in keeping with your region's plant and vegetation, especially the more natural plants that you can put into your landscaping, the better. It's going to be more economical, it's going to be more efficient, and they're going to stay true, and they're going to stay green, and they're going to stay growing over time because it's natural to the region. Use as many of those type of plants as possible and make sure that you're having those conversations at the local nursery when you go by over there. Now, another thing is, if you don't have a front tree, plant one. Planting a tree is a great thing to do, and it's also going to come with the benefit of reducing your summer electric bills by reducing the amount of sun onto your home. A shade tree is awesome. Now, if you're uncertain about where you can go, you can simply go over to the really fun to use National Tree Benefit site and use their tree benefits calculator. Again, the link's going to be below so that you can go over, check it out, and see what's going to work best for you. Now, the seventh upgrade that you want to consider is a basement makeover. And hey, if you don't have a basement, go ahead and skip on to the eighth point. But for those of you that do have a basement, doing a basement makeover is going to add value to your home. Converting the basement, especially into a finished basement, if you have an unfinished basement, is going to add square feet. It's going to add value to your home because you picked up more square feet. I mean, think about it. If you got a 600 square foot basement, right, and it's unfinished right now, and let's say homes are selling in your area for something like $200 a square foot, if you add 600 square feet to your property, what's your return on that? Well, take 600 square feet, multiply it by 200. What's that come up to? A whopping $120,000 by just finishing the basement and ensuring that it gets counted into your square feet. Now, making sure that it gets counted in your square feet means that you need to do what? You need to go and check and see if you're going to need any permits for doing that project. And you're going to have the city come back out there to reassess your property. Yes, your property taxes are going to go up in the process because your home is now worth more and it's now a bigger home. At the same time, the trade-off is going to be a higher sales price when the time comes. And while you're living in your home, guess what you have? You have the benefit and enjoyment for your basement being completed. Now, a few different ideas that are very popular for basement makeovers include doing like a sports den, have a big screen TV, a 75, 85 inch, whatever, maybe even a projection screen, have your sports memorabilia out, overstuffed couches, cushy carpeting, make it the place to be for you and your friends and your family or whatever you choose to do. Sports den is a very popular concept. Another one is a lounge. So, you know, that really cool vibe that you get, something that you go out and you spend money to do, you could have it right at your home with your own pool table, with your own wet bar, with your own dark hardwood floors and your own poker table. It's something that you can do that's going to be really, really cool for you and something that you're going to have a good time with. The third really popular option here is a children's play area. If you have kids, you have babies, whatever, that's one really important option that a lot of people have with a nice little play set, some soft furniture like beanbag chairs, soft floors, and just some table and bins and shelves for toys and things that the kids can play with and have a good time. I've also seen where people like to talk about turning them into ladies' caves, man's caves. I mean, the options for a basement are essentially endless. It could be a home theater room. I mean, it's literally endless. It's just whatever you want to do to it, it's going to add value when it's finished, and you're going to get the return out of it when you close on your home, when you sell it, okay? The eighth upgrade that you want to do is additional storage. Now, it comes as no surprise, no shock, that storage is a massive factor in a house. I mean, when's the last time you bought something new? And maybe you bought like a deep fry cooker or something like that, or an air fryer or something like that, and you were like, oh, where am I going to put it? I got no storage. And now you're in the garage, or you're going in the attic, you're going in the basement, you're trying to find a spot for your newest appliance. It's annoying as heck. The same thing is like if you have a growing family and you're getting additional plates or additional silverware, what have you, and now you're trying to figure out where you're going to put everything, right? It's annoying. So you want to make sure that if you have the ability to add additional storage to your home, that you do so. It's going to add value to your home. Take a page from like the new home builders. In this case, the new home builders are getting it right. Most new homes have a lot of additional storage. In fact, they probably have too much storage. Well, I guess it really just depends on whether you think a home could ever have too much storage. I personally think that more storage is better, even if you're not using the storage. The fact that it's there and inside the home that you purchased is a great thing because it gives you the opportunity to have space and to grow with the storage available. So take a page from them and go ahead and look at what you can do to add additional storage to your home. Now, some homes just may be, it is what it is, right? But there still are things that you can do. Go look at your closets. Go look at how you can organize the space that you have, your pantry space, your cabinets that you already have. Maybe a simple rollout into the cabinet can really benefit you by giving you an additional use and provide additional space. The space is the same, but the use is now different. Become more functional with rollout drawers, right? Think about that. Go to a home that has them if you don't have them in your home. See what you think about that concept and see how it really would apply to living in the home. When you're thinking closets, think California closets. Going into style and organized closets, it's going to really add a lot of utilitarian value to your property, and people are going to see that and be like, you know what, this didn't seem like such a big closet, but because they went the extra length and made it storage friendly, I really like this house and I need this house because it already has everything for my storage needs. And it could make your house the one that they want to buy and make your home the popular one on the block whenever it comes time to sell. Something to think about, something to consider. Additional storage is critically important. Okay, so the ninth upgrade, the last one we're going to talk about today, is the little touches mean a lot. And what do I mean by little touches? It's the little things that count. We all know that, and it's the attention to detail that really gets a lot of people's interest when they see all these beautiful upgrades, all these beautiful renovations that you've done to the house, and then they're like, oh wow, they did not skimp on even the small stuff. It makes your home pop, from everything from the alarm system to the water filtration system, on into, if you have a luxury home, maybe adding the home theater system and having it ready to go as a nice little staging concept, just saying. If you have the little popcorn machine in the corner, it's pretty cool. It's a good touch if you have that ability to do it. So there's a lot of things that you can do just with attention to detail in your home, making sure that all the paint looks good, make sure that you're maintaining the home, your baseboards are in good condition. All of these things make your home pop when it comes time to sell it. At the same time, you get to enjoy it while you're living it. So whether you're planning on selling the home soon or whether you're planning on owning your home for another 10, 15, 20, 30 years, you'll get massive enjoyment out of it, knowing with a peace of mind that you did your renovations correctly, your upgrades are done correctly, and people are going to love your home when it comes on the market. As a final point, I'm going to give you a pro tip, and that is to choose your home improvements wisely. Make sure that whatever you do to your home is in keeping with your neighborhood. Don't go overboard with your home improvements if all the homes around you are selling at like maybe $500,000 and now your home should be worth like $600,000. If all the homes around you are only worth $500 and yours is $600, what do you think the odds realistically are going to be of you getting $600 for your home? It's not that it's impossible, but it's going to be very, very tricky, and it's going to take longer to get, and you're going to have to make sure that right buyer's in the market at the right exact time when you get ready to sell it. The best way to do home improvements, the best way to do your renovations, is to look at what the average property value is around you, what kind of upgrades are your neighbors doing, what kind of upgrades are people expecting whenever they purchase a home, and plan it out from there. And make sure that you are very, very smart about this and take it over a course of time. This is not a race, it is a marathon. You can do and pace your home renovations out in a way that makes sense to you fiscally with your budget, and it's a way that makes sense to you for what you would like to get done in your house while you're living there, and it's going to add to your resale value when the time comes to sell it. Now, here's what I want you to do. Tell me what you're thinking about this episode in the comment section below, along with any of your savvy home improvement and home upgrade tips with us. Let's continue to learn and grow together. I'm going to go ahead and pop up my contact information. If you simply want to drop me a line to say hello, or if you need help finding a top agent where you live, please let me know. I always love to hear from you, and I'm always here to help you. If you haven't already done so, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, please subscribe to this channel. Number two, please like this video. And number three, please share this video around with someone you know is going to be able to help, because just like you, I'm sure you can think of just one other person that's wondering what upgrades or home renovations should I be doing that's going to actually boost my home value. Share this video with them. It'll really help them out and get them started on the right track too. Thank you so much. And between now and next time, I'm wishing you and yours a lifetime full of love, wealth, abundance, and happiness. Thank you for watching today, team, and enjoy an amazing day.